Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of U.S. tech giants Apple, Alphabet, and Meta. The European Union opened an investigation into the three companies in the first probe under its sweeping Digital Markets Act tech legislation, which requires firms to comply with guidance to ensure a level playing field for their rivals. All stocks are down in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of Zoom Video Communications. It unveiled an AI-powered collaboration platform designed to enhance productivity. Zoom shares are up about 1% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of British home improvement group Kingfisher, which fell as much as 3% after the company issued its third profit warning. Kingfisher shares are recovering. It last traded lower by a fifth of a percent.
Asian markets kicked off the shortened trading week lower. Japan's Nikkei 225 led declines with a more than 1% drop. The Singapore Straits Times Index also falling after the city-state reported a higher-than-expected February inflation report, with core inflation rising to a near one-year high. Philippine shares joined the downsizing dragged by net foreign selling, which came in at 246 million pesos.
The default is if there is a long weekend ahead, investors tend to take profits.
Okay.
Of course, number one, we're going to be facing a long vacation, and with long vacation comes, you know, quite some spending. So some investors may tend to liquidate funds in order to use them during the vacation period. Number two, of course, with the long vacation comes a lot of uncertainties ahead. And investors would want their funds to be shielded from the said uncertainties, the things that could unfold, during from Monday, Thursday to Sunday, on Friday or on Friday and Saturday, we're going to see the U.S. PCE,
right,
or PCE inflation. So there are a lot of uncertainties on down the road, and investors would want to be shielded from that. So they may take profits for the time being.
Another word war erupts between the Philippines and Manila after Beijing's latest maritime aggression injured three Filipinos. Manila's Foreign Affairs Department has summoned the Chinese embassy's chargé d'affaires over the March 23 incident. It has also instructed the Philippine embassy in Beijing to lodge a protest with the Chinese Ministry of Foreign Affairs, the Chinese embassy firing back with its own protest. The embassy asserts Philippine vessels illegally entered into Renai Zhao, which is China's designated name for Ayungin Shoal. It also claims the Philippine resupply vessels attempted to transport construction materials to what it called an illegally grounded warship, the BRP Sierra Madre. Beijing has slammed Manila for not honoring its word after promising to remove the warship. Malacanang has denied knowing about such an agreement.
The Philippines has repeatedly promised to tow away the warship as soon as possible. But more than 20 years have since passed, and the Philippine warship is still grounded in the same place. The Philippines went back on its word, reneged on its promise, violating the commitments it has made to the Chinese side on many occasions.
The Philippine National Defense Secretary, for his part, dares China to put its maritime sovereignty claims to international arbitration.
Kung talaga siguro hindi sila natatakot na ihayag sa buong mundo ang kanilang claim, bakit hindi tayo magpa-arbitrate sa ilalim ng international law para maliwanag sa lahat kung ano ang karapatan ng kahit sino? Bakit ayaw nila?